everyone, welcome back to Mamta Nivall tutorial. And guys, in this video we're going to start a new chapter, which is chapter number 5. This is the chapter of class 6 and the name of the chapter is separation of substance. Okay, what we need to study in this chapter is how we separate the substance. What are the substance? Any object which is around us is made up of some kind of a substance, and if we need to remove them, we need to separate them, we should learn some kind of methods, and those methods are learned from this chapter. Okay, we will understand what methods we can use so that we can separate the substances which we require or which are the useful substance. Okay, like in our daily life we used to separate lot of things. Okay, what kind of things? Like tea leaves. From the prepared tea we used to stain the tea through a strainer so that we can remove the tea leaves on the strainer and our tea will be inside our cup. Okay, so this is the strainer which we use to separate the tea leaves from the prepared tea. Okay, now we also when grain is separated from the stalk. If we bring a packet of grains from the market, we will see that there is not only the grains, there are some stalk and other particles also. If we need to remove them, that removal is also require the separation process. So what kind of a separation we are requiring, we will study those concepts also. Okay, like in the previous class, in previous chapter we have learned like ginning is the process from which we can remove the cotton fiber and the seed. Okay, with the help of comb we remove these two also. So what is this removing? This is removing, it is separating. We are separating the cotton fiber and the seed from each other. Okay, so this is kind of a things which we daily do. Like if we are eating poha or any food, if you think that it is more spicy, there are lot of spices in it, or there are lot of chilies. Okay, there are lot of chilies in it, we can remove that chili, remove all those chilies which we do not need to eat, and then we eat our food. So this is also a process of separation which we do on our daily basis. Like in curd, when we churn the curd, what we do, due to the churning process, the curd will remove the butter from it. Okay, so we are separating butter from it. So that separation is also which we do in our daily life. Like, let's take an example, a simple example to understand this concept. This is a basket and it contains some mangoes. Okay, we'll change the color. This is the apple. Let's take an apple. This is the apple. Three apples we are having and there are some mangoes in it. Okay, now these are the mangoes. If we have a basket which contain mangoes and apples and anyone say that we need to remove them, so how we can separate them? So we will take two baskets, one here, and what we do, we just simply pick all the apples and put on in one basket and pick all the mangoes and put in another basket. So this is the simplest way what we have done. We just pick them with the hand and separate these two in other baskets. So this is a normal process of separation. But if we have a mixture, of sand and salt, can we separate sand from salt with the help of hand picking method? No, we can't. It is impossible to separate sand from the salt with the help of hand picking process. So we require different kind of methods. We'll need to learn different kind of methods so we can separate the sand and salt also. Okay, so we will study about it. First of all, you should know what are separation and why we require separation. Separation means sorting out things, okay? Anything is removed from other thing is known as the separation, okay? So, why we need separation? We need to separate harmful or non-useful things from each other, okay? Non-useful things from our food. Like initially we have taken an example of the hair, grain and stalk. Stalk are not the important portion which we need to eat. No, we need to remove them. We need to separate it so that we can make grain and make food out of it. Only grain is required. So the grain is the useful portion and the stalk is the non-useful portion. So we are separating the non-useful, we can say that harmful things from our food or any other products, okay? This is why we require separation. Why else? Maybe we need to make the food separately. Like we have a mixture of two pulses and we need to make the two pulses independently, okay? So we are making them separately so that we have separated it so that we can fulfill our needs, okay? Now, what are the separated particles? What are their natures? The particle which we separate, it can be harmful, it can be useful, it depends on our need. But it can have different shape, different size. Okay, it do not like the separated particles also have same shape and same size and we need to separate them. No, it may be possible, it may not be. So they may have different shape, different size. Even the state of matter can also be different. That means the separated particle can be solid, it can be liquid, it can be a gas particle. Okay, we can separate any of them. So the main important question is, how do we separate different substance mixed together if they have so many different properties? So it is very difficult to separate that kind of a mixture which have so much variation in their properties. How we can separate them? To separate them, what we require, we need to learn some methods so that those methods will help us to learn or help us to separate those substances. First method is the hand picking method. Hand picking, this is the easiest way of separation. Like similarly, we have taken a packet of grain. You go to the market and bring a packet of food grain which you need to make food out of it, okay? Now we have taken the grain, the packet of grain, okay? Now take a sheet and now spread it all over that sheet. What you see in it, there is not only grain is present, we will see some other substance also. Like what that packet contain is grain, stones. There will be some stones which you can see, husk is the portion which we use for the fodder of the animals, or broken grains, okay, broken part of the grain, or maybe a particles of different or another particles of any other grain. It can be, it's true, it can be. Like we can see lot of other things also in it. It's not just grain which we brought from the packet or we brought from the market, that packet, okay? Now why we require, or how we can say when we can have the hand picking method, when we can use the hand picking method to separate. For that, we should require a larger size impurity, which we need to remove. So the impurity size should be little big so that we can see with our naked eyes and we can pick it up. So the size of the particle or impurity, like stone has a big size, we can remove it. If we talk about just dirt or just soil, if we talk about the dirt, okay, so that dirt also, it can be very fine dirt, so we cannot hand pick it, we cannot pick them up from the grains so that we can remove that dirt. No, that stone, that husk, we can remove because they have a larger size. So if we need to remove a larger size impurity, we can use a hand picking method. For other things, we have other method. Like second method is the threshing method. Where we use it, we know mainly the farmers use this method. Like after the harvest of wheat field, W-E-A-T, wheat field, okay. After the harvesting of it, what they do, they make a bundle of these plants, make some bundles and leave it there in the field, okay. They lie in the field itself, okay. They leave it there so that the sun will do his work. What the sun? Sun will make them dried so that the portion, this is an example. If we take a plant, this is a plant and these are the leaves, and this is the portion where we are having that grain, that portion, okay. Now these are the food, these are the seeds which we need to remove. We cannot remove one by one the all the grains from it, all the weeds from it. No, we cannot do by hand picking. So we require a different kind of a method for that. So to remove the stalk and the grain from each other, what they do, they beat those stalks. What they do, they take that bundle, they pick it up and start beating on a place, a stone, so that after that beating, what it happened, the stalk and the grain will be removed because they have dried in the sun. After the drying, it is more easy to remove the grain portion and the stalk portion. And sometimes this process is also done by with the help of bullocks also, okay. It depends on the farmer to farmer which they need, they feel more convenient to. So this is the method which we call threshing method. We need to pick the bundle of the harvest wheat, that whole plant we are taking, and now we have dried that in presence of sun, and now we beat it to free the grains and the stalk portion from that branch or from that plant. Okay, this is the method called as threshing. Next method is the winnowing method. This is also a very good method. Like after getting the threshing method, after getting what we get from this is the grain and the stalk portion. They are mixture of it. Okay, here we have not separated them. They are, both of them are present here. Now what we can do, a farmer, what he do, on his shoulder length, he keep a board and take some of the portion of this grain and stalk. Okay, here they are taking grain as well as stalk. What it do, when the direction of air is here, this is the direction of air. Okay, due to that air pressure, the heavy material, the heavy grain will settle down on the ground at this place, and the the stalk portion, the portion which we do not require, that portion is very light, so that they can go away with the help of that wind pressure, and they can make a heap here. This is the portion which is the husk portion which we do not require. So we are removing that husk and that grain with the help of winnowing process. Okay, here this is the man who is helping to remove all these things. How they can remove the grains? The grains are heavier, so that they can settle down here only, and the stalk were very very light, so that all the husk or stalk will be moved with the help of air. Okay, so this is the process when we require to do winnowing process. Okay, you should understand when we need to do that, when we need to separate heavier and lighter component. Okay, we should require two type of component, heavier and lighter component. If we need to separate them, we require winnowing process. Okay, next, another method we can use is the sieving method. Like normally we sieve our floor. First example, in our daily life we used to sieve the floor. Okay, before making the chapati we need to make a dough, and that dough should be made up of flour which is sieved. Okay, what is the sieving? Sieving is this kind of a thing which have lots of pore in it, so that we can put anything on it and we can move it from here to here, here to here, we in this direction. So all the particles which is smaller than those size of the hole of that strainer, so all those things will go under or go pass through the holes, all those things will pass through the holes, and this larger size impurity or particles will remain on the upper side of the sieve. Okay, so this is also a way we can separate two impurities or separate two substances. Okay, like in flour meals we require sieving method, in flour meals we need sieving method. In construction site when we require, normally you have seen a this kind of a structure in the construction site where this is a sieve, and they whatever material they need to use, like cement or bajri or any other product they need to use in the construction, what they do, they need to separate it from this strainer or this this sieve. Okay, so this sieve will help to remove all that sand which is required for our construction, and all the stone will be on the upper portion of it, and so we can remove it from our material which we require in the construction method. Okay, other thing is the other we can say that if the object is very small and if we cannot hand pick it or remove it by staining or other sieving process, what else we require? This is also a good process which we call sedimentation. Okay, and sedimentation will also contain decantation as well as filtration. All these three process will go with one by one. If we need to filter anything, we need a clear thing, we require sedimentation, decantation and filtration method all together. Okay, what is sedimentation? Like when we wash rice or any pulse, what we do, we take a beaker and put the rice in it and put some water into it. Okay, so the substance which is heavier to the density of the water, they will sink in the bottom, and the particle which is lighter or have less density than water, they will float on the surface, so that we can remove those impurity from the food which we need to prepare. we can use water in it. Okay, so this is also a way how we can separate the two impurity or two particles. Okay, like while cooking, we require this process very oftenly. Water has always have this property that the heavier particle, the particle which is heavier, then that will settle down and the lighter particle will float on it. So this is the process is known as sedimentation. Okay, now another method after the sedimentation, what we require is decantation. What that means, decantation is the when the water is removed, like this is the container, here we are taking the our food, and this is the impurity which is present. This is the impurity which is floating on the water. Now we need to remove it. What we do, we need to remove all this water into another container so that we can use this food as to make our food. Okay, this grains to make our food, we can use them. So this removing of water from one container to a drainage or another container, this removing of water is known as decantation. So this is the removed water is the decantation. Okay, now another is the filtration. I hope you have understand the sedimentation and decantation process, but with the help of filtration we can get a very fine filtered product. Like for example, if we need to separate tea leaves, we have prepared a tea liquid and now we need to separate them, we can use sedimentation as well as decantation so that we can remove the tea leaves of it. But still we are not removing it very finely, there will be some particles of the tea leaves present in our tea. Why it is so? Because it is not that much efficient. But if we take filtration process that will completely remove all the tea particles and we will get only liquid portion which we require. So with the help of a strainer we can do the filtration. So they are more efficient, filtration process is more efficient so that we can get a very pure product. For example, if we have a container and it contain water, this is containing water and some liquid, water and some liquid which is oil. What the oil do not mix, this is the oil and this is the water. Oil do not mix with water, we already know that concept. So what it do, it will make a proper layer on it. If we keep it for some time, let's do not disturb it for some time, you will see that oil will come on the surface and make a separate layer. We can use that separate layer, we can separate it in another container and we can separate the oil from the water. This is the process where we require only sedimentation and decantation. We do not require filtration in this concept. So sedimentation and decantation is required only. But if we have a muddy water, we need to remove that mud from our water. This is our water, chicken. This is muddy. Okay, after some time, if we keep it for long time, what we see, all the mud will settle down, but there will be some particles in the water too. So those the water is not that much pure that we can drink it. No, it's not. So that removal of bigger particles of sand from the solution, we can use the sedimentation and decantation sedimentation and decantation process. Okay, in decantation we are removing this portion of water in another container. Now this portion of water contains some particles of sand and water. Now what we can do, we can take a filter paper and put that filter paper on another beaker and pour this liquid in this container. What we see that only the pure water will be stained or filtered. This is the pure water, and all the dirt and the soil particles will be on the filter paper. So this is how the filtration help in our filtering or separating to substances. Okay, so it depend on our need, what kind of a need we are having, so we can separate the different kind of particles. Okay, like for example, if we need to make a paneer, okay, what we need to make a paneer, we need to separate that mixture of the milk, the condensed milk, or we can say that the clots of the milk, and the remove all the water out of it. So we can take a fine clothes and put all these mixture into it, and what we do, all the water will come out from the pores of the liquid and we will get our paneer in it. So it depend on our need, which process we require. We require sedimentation, decantation and filtration, all, or just filtration, or any of them. It depend. Now the fourth method is the evaporation. Like if we have an example like salt, how we can get the salt from the sea water? What we do, we collect the sea water in a shallow pit. What we do, we collect the water in a shallow pit. Here all the water is collected. Now we heat that water with the help of sunlight. Okay, what the sun will help us to heat it with the help of sunlight. Because of that heating, the water will evaporate, the water will become vapors, and due to the evaporation of water, only the salt will left in the shallow pit which we have made, or we have collect all the water as well as the salt into it. So all the water will evaporate because of the heat, and we will get the salt portion. Sometimes we require more than one method of separation. Okay, for example, if we are taking a mixture of sand plus salt, how we can remove this mixture? So we require more than one type of method to separate them. For example, what we do, we take that mixture in a beaker and we add some water into it. Okay, what the water will dissolve the salt. So this water will contain salt and water portion, and this will contain the sand, because sand is a heavier, so it can be settled. So this is the process which we call as sedimentation. With the help of sedimentation the sand will settle in the bottom of the container. Now with the help of decantation, this is the process decantation we are using. Decantation, we remove that water containing the salt portion. Okay, salt in it. Now we can do the filtration, or we do not require, it's okay. With the help of, if we require filtration, so that all the sand particle will be removed from this solution, so we can use filtration process also. Now what next we can do is the transfer of the liquid, this liquid, transfer the liquid into the kettle. Okay, now what we have done, we have transferred this into a kettle. This is a kettle and we are heating. Here is all the solution into it. Okay, and we are heating it. What, due to this heating process, all the vapors, water will evaporate, and that evaporation will make that water to become vapors, or we can say steam. Okay, from the mouth of the, or we can say that the mouth of the kettle is the spout. So from the spout, all the steam will come out, and that steam, that hot steam, can be with the help, or can be condensed, that steam, with the help of a metal plate. So what we can do, the particle which is coming from out of it, which are the steam portion, we can take a plate and put it here on the place above the snout, so that all the vapors will touch here on the metal plate, and we are placing some ice on it. This is the ice cube. Because of that ice, all the water vapors will condense and form and convert into a liquid, and we can drop by drop collect all those liquid into another container. So we have removed water here, salt will be remain here, and sand is here. So we have separated all three components which we need to separate, but we require different separation method to do so. Okay, so this process is known as condensation. Condensation means to condense the water is in gaseous form, the vapors form, because of the contact of ice, or because of contact of that plate of very low temperature, due to which the vapors become condensed and they form liquid, and that liquid we can collect in another container. One more concept is come under it is the saturation. What is saturated solution? Sometime we have seen that if we have taken some sugar, okay, and this is the water, we added 1 spoon of sugar into the water, it completely dissolved. After that we have added two spoons of sugar, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6. After one time there will be a point where the sugar will stop dissolving. Now there we cannot dissolve more sugar in it. That is the stage which we called as the saturated stage. Okay, this is the saturated stage of that solution. Now more sugar cannot be dissolved, but we can resolve this kind of a problem if we require to dissolve more solid or more solute portion into the solvent. We can heat it up. So heat will help us to dissolve more objects or more solute into it. So similarly in this concept, if we have more quantity of salt is present, so we require more quantity of water too, so that the water will dissolve proper amount of salt which is present in that mixture, so that we can get all the salt, because if the mixture will become saturated, so maybe there is a chances that some salt will remain in the sand portion, which is not separated from sand and salt. So to separate it clearly or completely, we do not make the mixture as a saturated mixture. We require more water, and we can use more heat, so that if we use heat in it we can say that our water will contain more salt into it, because heat will help to dissolve the salt in more quantity. Okay, so this is what in this chapter. I hope you understand this complete chapter. If you have any doubt, please ask me, and If you like my video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe my channel. And thank you guys for watching this video.